Welcome to Learning to Engineer. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the circuit breakers. A circuit breaker is a device that protects the load or the circuitry from the fluctuations in the supply. Due to overload or overcurrent or any other ground faults or any other faults, the current that is sent to the load may be rapidly increasing. It will increase from 11 ampere to something like 50-60 amperes. So this will cause heating of the device and it will damage the device. So for that purpose, we have a circuit breaker. If a circuit breaker is rated at 32 ampere, that circuit breaker will not allow the current more than 32 ampere to be passed through the load. The circuit breaker will be designed based on the load's rating capabilities. So in general, circuit breaker is a device that drips the current that is passing through the load in case of abnormalities. There are three kinds of circuit breaker. One is the standard one, which is a single and double pole, which is what is used domestically. And next we have a ground fault interrupter and then arc fault interrupter. Many of you might think that both ground fault and arc fault are the same, but it isn't same. Ground fault is different, arc fault is different. I'm going to explain you in the later part of the video. Okay, so before that, let us first understand what a circuit breaker is and how it works. Okay, a circuit breaker has a contact and then a pivot or an interrupter basically. Okay, under normal conditions, this live wire will be carrying the current. This will be touched by this contact and it will be later connected to the load or the system to which this current is being supplied to. In cases where the power or the current increases, the increase in the current will cause the coil to get magnetized and then there will be a motion in this part, in this contact area, because of which the spring will lose its tension and then it will be tripping off. So this will be separated. This will cause the current flow to get obstructed. Okay, so in cases where the current exceeds the rated value, this contact will be separated and the current will not be passed to the circuitry. So this device protects the load. This is a basic working of a circuit breaker. We will go in specific about ground fault and arc fault interrupter. What is ground fault? When a hot wire or a current carrying wire, by mistake, if it shorts to ground, the ground's potential will rapidly increase. This will damage all the devices that are grounded to that point. That is called as ground fault. It is caused by loose wiring or improper wiring, or when you connect the components not in a specific manner. When there are internal shorts in a circuit, this will cause ground faults. Let us talk about arc faults. The arc faults will cause firing. The arc fault is a place where the wire gets excessively heated up and it causes fire. This scenario happens in power stations, in industries where the power is very high, it will be like 14,000 volt or something which is very high. When such a huge power is transmitted to the load, in those cases you will be facing arc faults. That is why the substations will be equipped with SF6 circuit breaker or a circuit breaker that is capable to handle that much current. Let us discuss about SF6 circuit breaker. The sulfur hexafluoride or SF6 is capable to extinguish current because of its electronegativity. What is electronegativity? Electronegativity is when an atom is capable of pulling the electrons from the neighboring atom to that atom. That capability is called as electronegativity, or the tendency to be more electronegative so that it will attract the photons from the neighboring atoms to it. That is called as electronegativity. SF6 or sulfur hexafluoride is a highly electronegative element. So for that reasons, we are using it in circuit breakers. There are other advantages too. It is not inflammable and it is safe to use and it is odorless. So it is very stable at room temperatures too. So that is why we are using it very safely in circuit breakers. Let us first understand how the circuit breaker works. As you are seeing in this image, there are two contexts. One is a fixed one and the other one is a moving one. Under normal operations, the fixed contact and the moving contact will be separated apart. Under normal operations, the current will pass from the fixed contact to the moving contact and then to the load. So, in normal operations, the SF6 gas will not be passed into this arcing chamber. When the current exceeds the load, the moving contact will be forcefully pushed into the fixed contacts. There will be holes in the fixed contacts to accept the moving contacts, and in this process, SF6 gas will be injected from the high pressure reservoir to a low pressure reservoir. What is this high pressure reservoir? This reservoir will be containing the SF6 gas. Under high pressure, it will be sent to the chamber. When this gas is entering the chamber with high pressure, what will happen? Because of its high electronegativity, it will absorb the free ions, or what is current basically? It's just movement of electrons, right? So, when SF6 is pumped into the arcing chamber, it will absorb the current or the excess electrons, and it will not let the electrons get passed into the moving chamber into the load. So, what happens? This saves the equipment from damage. It causes an interruption. Just like how you saw in this circuit, the contacts will get separated mechanically. But now, we are passing this gas into the contact where the power supply meets the load's wires. So, what happens? This causes the current flow to get interrupted, and then it will save the device. Arcing is a phenomenon where a live wire gets burned due to excessive heat. So, all this will be absorbed by the SF6 gas and then it will be pumped into the low pressure reservoir. We have this because SF6 is a very costly element. In India, it will be around 1,100 rupees per kg of it. So, this is very costly. For every operation, we can't be spending for SF6 again and again. So what people do, they have a low pressure reservoir in the other end of the tube, and they will be connecting the high pressure gas which flows into the chamber into this low pressure reservoir. So once this gas is entering the low pressure reservoir, it will be collected inside for the next operation. After this happens, it will be pumped to the high pressure reservoir where the piston moves forcefully up, thereby reducing the volume of the cylinder. When the volume of the cylinder reduces, the pressure builds up inside that gas chamber. So, when the gas is sent into the arcing chamber, what happens? The gas will be sent in a very high pressure, thereby it can absorb more ions, and then it will move into a low pressure reservoir. This is how SF6 circuit breaker works. Thanks for asking this question. I hope I have answered you. Do let me know your thoughts in the comment section. If you have any further doubt, please ask me. I'll be happy to explain you further.
Subscribe to my channel for more updates. Thank you.